Hello viewers, welcome to the course on Fundamentals of Horticulture. Today we are going to discuss about the third unit of the course, which is Orchard Soil Management and Systems of Irrigation. Orchard soil management refers to the management of the orchard soil in such a way as to get the higher yields of good quality fruit over the years. Well-managed soil results in optimum tree growth and good yields. Types of soil management systems. The choice of soil management system depends on altitude, kind of fruit trees, rooting depth of trees, topography, rainfall, climatic conditions, and economic conditions of the farmers. The commonly known and practiced soil management systems are clean cultivation. It means keeping the land of orchard always free from grasses or any other vegetation. It controls the weed growth, improves moisture retention, aeration in soil, and increases nutrient availability. Under continuous clean cultivation without the addition of organic matter or growing any leguminous crop, the soil became depleted of nutrients. The second management technique is sod culture. In this system, a suitable grass or sod cover is grown in orchard and soil is not disturbed. Though no tilling is practiced, but sometimes soil is loosened with rake in spring. This improves aeration and water intake capacity of the soil. The key to good sod management is frequent cutting or moving of cover crop. It should be moved over after a month during May or June and twice in a month during monsoon when growth is very fast. Sod culture can be useful for loamy soils, but in steep areas it may not be of much use. Sods are better than weeds and wild grasses because they do not take much time to establish and their roots do not penetrate deeply. Suitable sods for different areas. Among legume crops, kudzu vine, lucerne, which is known as alfalfa, white clover, and red clover. Among non-legume crops, Timothy grass, orchard grass, ray grass, Kentucky bluegrass can be used as a sod among the orchards. Another management practice is cover crop. It means planting a crop in an orchard for providing cover to soil surface. Cover crops are useful because they are not only provide cover to soil during winter, but also prevent soil erosion during heavy rains. Crops like beans, soya beans, lentils, and sunflower helps to improve the physical condition of the soil. As you can see in this picture, and very well managed orchard, you can see a cover of grass between the two rows of the fruit trees. Another management practice is green manuring. To restore fertility and productivity, some crops are turned into soil while still they are green. This practice is known as green manuring. Plants of leguminosity group are generally used for green manuring. These crops are being capable of nitrogen fixing, add nitrogen in the soil, it improve physical property of soil also, and soil gets enriched with organic carbon. You can see in this picture that a farmer is turning its green crop into the field, which will become a good fertilizer for the coming crop. This slide shows the few plants which fixes nitrogen in the soil, like sunhemp, which fixes 134 kilogram of nitrogen per hectare Dhecha fixes 133 kilogram nitrogen per hectare. Likewise, Felice Pecera 102 kilograms, Sesbania rostrata 96 kilograms, guar fixes 91 kilograms nitrogen per hectare, and cowpea, which fixes 74 kilogram nitrogen per hectare. Guar, which has now also become a very good cash crop as its gum demand is very huge in various sectors of the world. Another management practice is intercropping. It means growing annual crops in between tree rows. This practice can be employed with income advantage in early years of an orchard's life. Since most of the orchard crops are perennial plants, they require a considerable long juvenile phase, which is usually 4 to 6 years, to complete their canopy structure to bear fruits. You can see in this picture that a farmer has utilized very beautifully the space between the two rows of a newly planted bare orchard. Another soil management technique is multiple cropping, which refers to multi-species crop combinations of annual and perennials with an existing stand of perennials. Coconut, areca nut, betel, black pepper, pineapple, coffee, and tuber crops form the best multi-story combination. In case of such cropping, leaf canopies of component crops occupy different vertical layers one after another. The taller component is tolerant of strong light and high evaporative demand, whereas the shorter components are shade-loving and like relative humidity. The combination utilizes soil air resources in a better way with much less competition. With the multiple cropping, we can utilize the space of our farm very judiciously. We can plant taller plants and shorter plants, and among them the medium sized plants, to get the maximum yield from the per unit area. Mulching. It is spreading of leaves, straw or inorganic matters around trees or on soil surface. Usually organic materials are spread, but even inorganic matters can be spread. Organic mulch conserves moisture by reducing evaporation, preventing emergence of weeds, and on decaying adds humus to the soils. All organic residues and farm waste can be used as mulch. Black polyethylene sheets are also used as mulch and have given good results, as you can see in the picture that the citrus plant is being covered with the black polyethylene mulch with a drip lateral. As mulch material blocks sunlight, weeds under mulch cannot emerge, which is evident in the below picture. This eliminates competition between trees and weeds. It keeps the soil warm in winter and cool in summer. Plastic mulch film thickness for different crops. For short duration crops like vegetables, the 25 micron film is recommended. For medium duration or early stage of fruit crops, 50 micron film is recommended. And for the crops like mango, citrus or medium grown trees, 100 micron film is recommended. Now we will discuss about the systems of irrigation. Water is supplied to plants through irrigation. The various systems of irrigation are check basin. In this system, in between two rows of trees, an irrigation channel is prepared. The channel is then jointed through square or rectangular shaped beds. The beds contain more than one tree. As it is evident in the picture, you can clearly see that the trees are formed in a check basin pattern. Next is furrow irrigation. This system is practiced in newly planted orchards, taking the plants in the center. An irrigation channel of 20 cm depth and 60 cm width is prepared. Water is saved as only limited area is wetted. Ring basin system. A circular ring in the periphery of plant is prepared to irrigate the plants. Ring is prepared away from tree trunk towards outer periphery of the tree. In between two ring basins, a sub-channel connecting the ring is prepared. The water flows through central channel and move ahead naturally after flooding two ring basins at a time. The ring basin pattern is clearly evident in the shown picture. Basin system. A proportionate to the size of the tree is prepared. The basins are then connected with each other with irrigation channel. The water moves ahead after irrigating individual basin of trees. Basin occupy very less area and very large area remains unoccupied, which can be used for intercultivation. This picture shows that individual fruit tree is given a individual ring basin. Flood system of irrigation. This system is very simple and easiest to practice. The water is allowed for irrigation without making any beds or any other configuration as in other methods. The water floods the entire field. This system is practiced in canal command area and is of no means in arid regions. The picture shows system of flood irrigation where the water flows freely on the surface of the land. Pitcher system. This system is especially a boon in arid region in view of limited water supply. The pitcher filled with water is buried in the periphery of individual tree where feeding roots are confined. The water is released slowly with the micropores available in the wall of pitcher and takes care of irrigation requirement of the plant. Normally, for a plant having 3 meter spread, 4 to 5 pitcher per plant would be sufficient. This picture shows that how a pitcher system of irrigation is practiced. Nowadays, nobody do this, but it is an ancient practice to save the water for irrigation. Drip irrigation system. Drip irrigation, also known as trickle irrigation or micro irrigation, is an irrigation method that applies water slowly to the roots of plants by depositing the water either on the soil surface or directly to the root zone through a network of valves, pipes, tubings, and emitters. The main principles of drip irrigation are: water is applied at low rates over a long period of time. Water is applied at frequent intervals. Water is applied directly to the crop root zone. Water is applied through a low pressure delivery system. This diagram shows a typical layout of drip irrigation system and its main components. As you can see in the picture, that there is a water source, there is a motor pump, the filtration unit, the sub main line, the main line, and the various valves to control the flow of water. The main part of the drip irrigation system is the lateral, which delivers water directly to the root zone of the plants in a fixed quantity. This picture shows that farmers are transplanting onion under drip irrigation system. You can see in this picture an excellent onion crop under drip irrigation system. The black colored drip lines are clearly visible, which contains the dripper or emitter. The emitter emits the water in fixed quantity in a fixed time. Now let us see how we can calculate the crop water requirement. The volume of water required in liter per day can be calculated by multiplying the mean pan evaporation for the month in millimeter per day, its pan coefficient, its crop coefficient, plant to plant and row to row spacing, and the wetting fraction, which varies from 0.3 to 1 depending upon the crop. Advantages of drip irrigation: saving of water by 30% to 50% as compared to conventional mode of irrigation. Yield increases from 50% to 90%. Reduction in fertilizer usage resulting in cost saving. Increased pest management efficacy. Cultivation of undulated land is possible. Efficient water management of heavy and light soils. Control of weed growth resulting in labor saving, improvement in quality of produce and early maturing. Drip irrigation is the very beneficial irrigation techniques for the farmers. The government of India is also promoting this irrigation technique for the benefit of the farmers by providing the subsidy on its installment. Dear viewers, today we have discussed about the various techniques of orchard soil management and different systems of irrigation which can be applied in doing horticultural crops. The orchard soil management is a very important aspect because soil is the medium where plant grows. If your soil is healthy and is full of nutrients, it will definitely give you a very high yield per unit area. We can manage the soil by adopting the techniques like clean cultivation, sod culture, multiple cropping, use of mulches, etc. Mulching is another technique which our farmers are using since very long time. Initially, they used to place organic material, the waste organic material around the crop to conserve the moisture. Nowadays, the technique has changed and farmers are adopting black polyethylene sheets to conserve the moisture, which also gives benefit during the winter season and summer season. The another aspect we discussed is the systems of irrigation. There are lots of systems of irrigation like check basin, ring basin, furrow irrigation, which has now not very popular in use. The very popular system of irrigation which is now practiced by the farmers and also promoted by the government of India is drip irrigation system, as it saves water up to 70%. It gives water directly to the roots of the plants. As a result of this, the cost of irrigation is saved to the farmer, the labor cost is saved, and he can also use fertilizer very precisely.